what happened in this book, but all I can tell you is this. Black people don't work like this. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Sesily, where I do book reviews, movie reviews, and anything in between. And today's video, I'm coming with a book review of a book that I was highly anticipating reading. Thanks to Chandler Ansley's channel, she did a kind of vlog of this book. And at first I was gonna do like a vlog of her vlog to kind of read along with her, but that didn't work out because I read too like slow. I didn't know where she stopped at, and it's been so long since I seen that video. I was just like, let me just read the book. And so that's what happened. I just read the book. Credence is the book review. Make sure you hit that subscribe button and hit that like button and comment below. Have you read this book? On to the book review. Yes, Credence. I just finished it yesterday night. I had to complete it. And let me tell you, I laughed. I laughed again. I laughed some more in this book. And then I just questioned my sanity of this family dynamic. Not family, but family dynamic. I don't know what happened in this book, but all I can tell you is this. Black people don't work like this. So first off, let's go with the premise of the book. So we have a girl named Tierney. She's 17 years old. Her parents have passed away because they have committed suicide. So Tierney is kind of left by herself. She has no siblings. She has no friends. All she has is her mother's personal assistant who is there. Come to find out, she actually has a uncle, not blood uncle, but a step uncle. Basically, her father's father married a woman who had a son, and that's how she has the uncle. So he's like, hey, I was in the will. If you like to come live with me for a while before you hit 18, you can. And then you can decide what you want to do with your life. And she's like, you know what? What the heck? I mean, California is boring. Let's go to Colorado. You know, Colorado has that weed going, so. But she doesn't say that. That's me. But anyway, she goes to Colorado. The uncle has two sons. I believe Noah is 20, and then there is also Caleb, who's 21. They're just a year apart. It goes from this kind of coming of age for Tierney into womanhood, basically, you could say, more or less, kind of thing. I didn't go through this as a woman. So yeah, that is basically the premise of the book. So from here on out, it is spoilers because I want to talk about this book and the beautiful laughs it gave me. I want to mention that in the review so you can feel my loving and heartfelt laughs. There's certain scenes I was just like, what are we doing? For me, it was funny. So if for some of you, it's not gonna be funny, but some of the scenes are just hilarious. I'm like, who says this during this moment? So again, spoilers. So here we go. So I'm gonna break this review up into basically the characters and break it off that way and talk about each character and kind of their plot line. So starting off with Tierney again. She is 17 years old and she's going into a home with three men. She's never lived with three men. She's only lived with her parents. She is never had that much attentiveness because her parents didn't really pay attention to her. So she is seeking attention, which is fine. I get it. But with her character that I didn't like is, it's not that the fact that she wanted attention from all three guys, it's the fact that she wants to sleep with all three guys that got me. Yes, she sleeps with her uncle, Noah and Caleb. Yes, I know. Where'd they do that at? Again, the whole time I was starting reading this and she was like, oh my God, my uncle is so good looking hot. And I'm like, okay, I'll give you that. You know, if you have an attractive uncle, you can say he's good looking. But when she goes past that, I'm just like, the whole time in the very beginning of the book, I was just like, this is totally not a black family. Because in a black family, once you say, that's my cousin, that's my uncle, it doesn't matter if they're blood or not, that is your cousin and that is your uncle. It was just so weird because they just totally threw out that plot or that familiness out of it because of the fact that they've never met before. So it's kind of like, well, we're not blood and we didn't grow up together, it's okay to sleep with each other. Which I was just like, again, this is not a black family. Tierney, like, sleeps with all of the guys. She has different emotions. Her character was very weird to me because there are times where she is wanting it but doesn't want it, and then there are times where she's like, I want to be with this person, but it may feel good to sleep with you in the time being. And I'm just like, can you pick, like, for real, can you just pick and be more decisive in certain points? I'm okay with having a character that's a little bit doesn't know what they want quite yet because they have yet to grow. But I don't like a character where it's almost like she is designing or they're designing, but they're still flip-floppy. And I'm like, so do you want that person or not? I'm confused. And so that's the thing with Tierney. I'm just like, So in the beginning, she sleeps with the uncle because she's like, it's my first time. I'm glad it's you. But as soon as she sleeps with the brothers, because they have a threesome, Jake, that's his name. The uncle's name is Jake. She tells Jake, and then pretty much that's it of them ever sleeping together. Although it's basically towards the end of the book, we're pretty much almost done with the book. So she's just like, once I had them, I no longer want you. Which I was just like, okay. When Tierney and Uncle Jay have, you know, one-on-one time together, he ends up telling his sons. He's like, yeah, I messed up. I really messed up. And you know what one of the sons says? Well, what if I wanted her? What kind of family dynamic is this? I know it's a bunch of guys, and there's already a premise before this that they kind of just sleep with different women, like, almost every night. Do you not guys feel like this weird is, like, your uncle or your father just slept with his niece? Even though we're not blood, we're not related, he just slept with his niece still. Okay, and along with Tierney, again, she's very flip-floppy, sleeps with Uncle Jake right after her 18th birthday, like literally right after. She has, for something that's not even a year-long book, it's only a couple months, and how they have such emotions for each other in the very beginning doesn't make sense to me. As we go along in the book, he's already like, oh my god, oh my god, oh my god. And I'm just like, girl, let me get my alcohol real quick because I need a drink. Ooh, good old vodka water. Ooh, you need some vodka water right reading this, I swear. All right, we're moving on to Uncle Jake. This one is going to be brief because his character, other than him sleeping with his niece, I wish this character would have been more of a father figure to her. He does display that role, but I wish it was strictly just a father figure where she's trying to go after him, but he's like stopping it, and he's like telling her, like, this is why you're doing this. And he does in the book do that, but I wish it was like no sexual friction or intensity with him particularly. Like, he would have been like, no, you know, I'm gonna stop you right there. I don't have that feelings for you. You're like 17 years old. You're still my niece. Like, I would have liked the book a lot better if that was more the premise with his character, specifically Uncle Jake. That's Uncle Jake. All right, on to my MVP of this book is Noah, because poor Noah. Poor Noah. I swear his theme song is Boys to Men, I Will Make Love to You. Only if I'll make love to you, like you want me to, and I'll hold you tight. All through the night, I'll make love to you, when you want me to, and I will not let go of you, tell me to. Yes. That's how I feel Noah was through this whole book, which he really is. He really is someone who was telling her, I'm not gonna like F you up. I'm just gonna make love to you. And I felt for Noah, like towards halfway through, I just felt for him because he's the one guy that even Tierney is like, I should be with Noah because he's the better one. He speaks to me. He talks to me. Well, speaking and talk is the same thing, but he talks to me. We discuss kind of deep things. You know, she talks about a suicide attempt with Noah, and they really connect with each other. And Noah is the only one out of the group who only got her one time. The others got her at least twice, and Noah was the only one that got her one time. And that was with his brother included. So Noah definitely is my MVP. I really fell for him at the end because I truly think he's such a sweet guy. He wants better for his life. He wants more than just living in Colorado. He actually is one of those people that wants to kind of explore the world and see what's going on. He basically is like,
I can show you the world.
Like, that is Noah in this whole book from the very beginning. Noah was the one that really made her feel a part of family, I think, more than Uncle Jake and definitely Caleb. He just was the whole time being kind, gentle. He was never forcing her to do something that she didn't want to do. And when she felt uncomfortable and ran away, he did not chase after her. He gave her space. And he was very much the guy I thought she should be with. So she just didn't have like the physical intensity that, you know, so many people look for. I wish there was a book of just Noah and him finding his love, because I would read that, because... And the final person we were going to talk about is Caleb. Caleb is the typical trope guy that, you know, girls are trying to change, or girls are trying to be that special one to them. Caleb is the one, he's the older brother, he's like 21, he's the one who cannot talk, or he doesn't choose to talk. We find out there is a childhood trauma that happened to him, which is very traumatic when you read it and actually like think about it, and you're just like, whoa. First introduced to Caleb, he actually sees Tyranny in the shop, and then he like pursues her to have one-on-one, and she hasn't even met him yet. She's like, oh, you're Caleb. And he like forces her up against the car, to the point where I'm thinking, is this gonna be a rape scene? Like, she said no like at least seven times before he even registered. I forget what she does or if she does anything, but I think Noah actually comes in and is like, what is going on? And then he stops. Noah tells him, this is our like cousin. Like, dude, calm down. This is not one of the girls. And that's how we're introduced to Caleb. I'm already defensive. I get that you're the dark one and you're the one who's like quiet, and we're supposed to be the ones like, the quiet ones. But the quiet ones are the ones you're supposed to look after. But I'm just gonna say right here, Tyranny ends up getting with Caleb. Now you're wondering, like, how's that happen? He doesn't talk at all. She speaks to him and she's just like, I wish he would talk to me. I wish he would say a word. I just wish he would talk to me. Caleb doesn't until the very, very end. He says some words. I mean, like a couple of pages till the epilogue, he says his first word. But the thing with Caleb, he's aggressive. He doesn't do anything special. He does have moments with her, but you don't know if he's just doing it just because it's kind of like the right thing to do, or is he doing it because he likes her? He just has, from Tierney's perspective, he has these intense eyes, and she's like, I'm scared of you and you make me scared. But at the same time, she's like, I want him. And again, that's the problem with Tyranny, because you don't know, okay, if you're scared of him and you still want him at the same time, I don't get it. I don't know. But Caleb is the one where you kind of don't know if he's a good guy at all. To find out that she gets with Caleb at the end, there's not enough sweet moments with Caleb, enough kind of really interaction with Tyranny to make you feel like this, yeah, I can see this. Like, he's trying to like communicate with her. He's trying, he's making steps. It's not till the very, very end that you start seeing a sweeter Caleb. And I'm like, dude, no, you're not getting me trapped. No, you lost me in the beginning when you tried to rape her and then you did some other stuff. He literally spits in her face, not in her face, but in her hair, spit and put slut on her forehead. Yeah, you kind of lost me there. You would have had to stop right there and then sweep the rest of the book. So no, Caleb, I was like, no. Noah, come on over here. We got you over here. So yeah, Caleb at the end, and even the epilogue, totally different Caleb. Even at the very end, they've been not seeing each other for 6 weeks. She goes back to California. He comes 6 weeks later, surprises her, and he actually speaks his words to her. It goes from there. That was a totally different Caleb. The Caleb we had before, which just seems like he was just driven by sex and just driven by aggression and all that. You really don't get any interaction between him and her that really is consistent. She does read books that he writes in, and she's like, oh my god, he writes, oh my god, this is about me, this is about me, and I'm just like, I think that would have been better if he actually took her to the books and actually opened up the books for her and be like, and she reads and she looks at him like, that's what you think, oh my god, and he just sits there kind of like, yeah, that could have put me back on Caleb's side a little bit more, but yeah, no. Overall, with this book, I can't even rate this book, honestly, because there's just, I mean, some of the one-on-one scenes, I literally laugh, because I'm like, who says this during this scene? Like, with the threesome, I was just like, what is going on? And then with, like, Caleb at the end, I was just like, Tyranny, decide, do you want it? Are you gonna run away? Or do you want it to be like forceful? Like, oh, play like you don't want it, but he's like, okay, I get it. I can't write this book. If you're a person where you're just kind of used to contemporary books and you like that feeling, you like that kind of slight intense feeling, this book, if you are not into, and it's not even incest, but that kind of thing where a girl kind of just sleeps with every single guy to try to figure out what's going on in her life, especially with her family. I mean, you may like this book, particularly for me. I don't know. You guys, I really don't know about this book. I just laugh every time. I just laugh because I really don't know about this book. So yeah, you guys, comment below. Let me know what you thought of this book. Again, I thought it was hilarious in certain parts, and comment below, let me know what you think of this book. What kind of rating did you get it? And did you like the dynamics of the kind of family, not family thing, and Tyranny kind of just sleeping with all three of them? How did that make you feel? And so make sure you like, comment, subscribe, and catch me on my next video whenever that shows up. Deuces.